Hey there, internet travelers. What can you learn from this video? So I haven't done this for a while. I haven't gone out and explored, but the first thing that came to my mind was this little area with these older homes. So I went around and looked on Google Maps, went into the street view, figured out where this was, and I'm at a loss to why this is the way it is, because, well, first of all, as you might be able to read up there, it says Blake Farmhouse. But then there's something a little more interesting. It says this: private property registered with the National Historical Society, access by permission only. So what is the historical significance here? Like, sure, it looks like a older, I guess maybe pioneer home. But if you notice back there, there's a sign next to the door, like one of those brass historical markers, signs that they might have around a town that you've grown up with. And so I go over, like, I'm not wanting to go in the house. That's my rationalization here. So we're just walking over. I came up and it didn't give me really any more information. Let's see. Hopefully you can read that. And yeah. I would walk around it, but like the sign said, right? Private property? No trespassing? That's a little strange. Why would a historical marker say reserved right there in the smaller sign? I don't know. Or have any sign saying what it is other than just a farmhouse. But yeah, I don't know about you. I'm always fascinated by these older abandoned buildings. And if you think that's strange, how about, it's just basically, think of it like this. It's just basically like smaller versions of like castles. So like castles over in Ireland, England, Europe, the rest of Europe, they won't be all together. Always. They'll be broken down. And people visit those all the time. Even try to preserve what's left of them and nothing else. But yeah. Some cool stuff. In case you're wondering, I'm over in the Bloomington area of St. George, Utah. And this is, let's see. From where I'm standing, okay, now I'm facing north, and over that way, not too far, is the bottom half of the Green Valley Loop, officially known as the Bear Claw Poppy Trail. And yeah, there's your little tour of another little site that you may not have known about. If you have any additional information about this, feel free to comment in the, well, leave a comment down below. And as always, y'all keep smiling.